Hello everyone, this is Ted with Oaxray, and today we're going to talk about how you can calculate your monthly sales tax due for your Amazon account. So once you start selling on Amazon and you start making sales in all the states, you have more than just a few items in stock, you're going to need to start collecting sales tax depending on what it is you're selling and depending on your state. I'm in the state of Virginia, so I did a quick Google search for Virginia sales tax. And the government website should come up. It is tax.virginia.gov, and I'm sure every state has their own website like this. I go to Business iFile here, and then it allows me to start my tax collection from here. And this is kind of the portal for Virginia, but everybody else is going to have a different looking portal. I'm just kind of showing you how to get that started. Every state will be different, but this is how I get started on mine. Had to set up an account here. Okay, so we get started on Amazon. We go to reports, and then we go to fulfillment. It's going to bring you to the fulfillment reports, and you click on all orders. From here, you go to download, and you select exact dates, and then you select whatever dates it is that you want to download. I'm going to go to some old dates, some stuff that's not really relevant right now. You can only do 30 days at a time, I believe, or 1 month at a time. So, and you just hit request download. It's going to take about 30 seconds, but whenever this is done, we can open up the program. Whenever everything is ready to download, just click on download, and it's going to download everything into your browser. Then we'll go over to our spreadsheet app. Once we're over to our spreadsheet app, we can simply hit File, Import. I like to use Google Docs, but you can use whatever it is that's best for you. Replace spreadsheet, hit Import, and you should be good to go. So whenever everything loads, you're going to come to a screen just like this. All we really need, depending on your state, you might need more information than I do for Virginia. But for me, I'm just looking for my total item sales. So I don't really need these columns. In my case, I'm going to delete them just for ease of use, kind of. I'm going to here view, freeze my first column, and then I'm going to sort by the ship state. For me, I'm doing Virginia, so I'm going to delete anything that is not Virginia. Then I'll go all the way down here, and sometimes things will be like Virginia will be VA, or sometimes it will be the full name spelled out Virginia. I think it depends on how someone input their information. So I'm going to go from the bottom and again remove any of these that aren't Virginia. And sometimes there'll be a few in here in the middle. So see a couple of Vermonts and Victoria here. Delete. And it looks like we have everything Virginia, so we just have to total everything up. Right here is the item price. Depending on your state, you might also have to charge for the shipping price also, so just be aware of that. There is possibility. And here we're going to insert the sum function. Sum. And then we're going to do whatever column it is. So this is C2 to C77. And that totals up your column. So in the state of Virginia, I sold $1,159.60. And you can double check and make sure that all these are for Virginia. It looks like everything is good. So in my state, my sales tax will be on $1,159.60. If you have a larger state, then you might have a higher tax rate as a percentage, but Virginia tends to be not very much. Even if total sales are $50,000, maybe $1,000 is actually taxes in Virginia. So larger states will have different amounts.
Thank you guys very much. Have a great day and make some money using Oaxray.
Please like and subscribe, and if you have a question about Amazon, put a comment down below, and I'll make a video about it as soon as I can.